So why don't we move ahead to our first presentation. Talking about sous vide cooking is the Common Cod Community Coordinator, Gina.
So again, I'm Gina, I'm the Community Coordinator, and that is a sous vide egg, poached, delicious, and it's cooked through sous vide. Sous vide is cooking under a vacuum. Oh, good, which in and of itself doesn't sound delicious, but it really is. The most important part of sous vide is maintaining a constant temperature for the food that you're cooking. You'll see that's kind of like a restaurant setup. It's got a food grade bin, and that funny thing is a temperature kind of checker. And it's kind of a, what's the word? Kind of a geeky, techie way to cook. That is the vacuum seal that you need on your food, but you can do it through water displacement. You don't need to have a vacuum sealer. Sous vide was actually invented in 1799, which I was shocked about. I thought it was like a product of the 60s. They first invented it to pasteurize food. So it was a food preservation method, but then it came back in the 60s and the 70s for actually cooking at fine French restaurants, actually started in Europe. That is how restaurants usually do it. It's the takes the air out vacuum sealer kind of a thing. We don't have one of those. What we do is we put our food in a water bath, and my husband, who's better at it than I am, he burps the air out of it by displacing the water, and we get it just the same way. So you don't need to buy a lot of gear to be able to sous vide. You can just do it that way. So that's my setup. I have an Innova. I really like it. It's a precision cooker. Sometimes restaurants will use this or a similar setup just in regular food grade bins like we've already seen. I think that's a really good way to do it because you can cook any size thing that way as long as you have a pot big enough. See, there's another one right there. You can even do several different kinds of food at once, all in different different Ziploc bags or vacuum sealed bags, and it gives you a lot of options. They have other things on the market too, really fancy ones. That's actually my kitchen. I put the foil over the top because as you cook, the water will actually, turn and it'll evaporate. So I put the foil on top so that my water doesn't all go when I cook for a couple of hours. That's the one, that's the sous vide, is for $4.99, you can buy this. I think it's a limited kind of style because you can only cook something smaller than that box. So that's why I like mine better because I can use any pot or pan to do it. I just throw it on the stove and that's it. So this is why I sous vide, because I really like rare steak. So this is all the temperatures you can get, starting from raw all the way to like totally overdone, in my opinion. I like a rare steak. So I will put a steak in a bag and put it, that's actually the steak that we ate this last weekend. Put it in a bag, water displaced, seasoned it already, and I put it in for the temperature that I want it to be. I then let it cook for 2 hours about, and then it's perfectly done all the way through exactly how it is. That's what it looks like when it comes out, which you're like, ew. It's a little sad, but in walks Auntie Bethy, who got the pancini. She's really nice, and she actually got us a blowtorch for Christmas, which is the gift that keeps on giving. There it is, and we were able to finish it that way. Now, there's another way that you can finish things with sous vide. You can take a beautiful cast iron pan, and you can just do it really quickly. I never do it fast enough, and I totally overcook the outside of it, and it gets all kind of gray. So the blowtorch was great for that. But my favorite all-time food to sous vide is eggs. And the reason why is I married into a very large family. We have brunches. We go through a dozen eggs. Poaching a dozen eggs is a lot of work. In the sous vide, it's not. Eggs are already in their own airtight container, so you just place them in the sous vide, in the shell. 45 minutes at 63 degrees, and any time after the 45 minutes, they're perfectly cooked. They can't overcook in the sous vide. That's the other magic of it. There's all the different kinds of cooked level you can get with an egg. I personally like the 63 degree temperature, but it's really fun to play around with, and you can experiment and see what you like for that perfect poached egg for your Eggs Benedict, and it's great for entertaining. Now, if you don't want to throw a lot of money at this hobby because of this wacky lady, the community coordinator is telling you it's the thing to do, you can just sous vide in a cooler with some boiling water and some corn. You just half fill the cooler with corn, and then the other half is boiling water. Cook it for 30 minutes and you're done. Under Pressure by Thomas Keller is a really important book for sous vide if you want to kind of read a little bit more. It's a great resource, but there's also free internet resources that are really great. The ANOVA website is awesome. That's the kind of brand that I have, but you don't need to have that, but they gave lots of recipes and tutorials. It's really good to check out. And then the last one is, I think it's gonna come up. Nope, I ran out of time, but it's J. Kenji Lopez Alt, Serious Eats. He does a whole thing on sous vide and it's really excellent. I recommend it, I use it all the time, and my time is up. Thank you very much.